And let's start our Clubhouse TLC Mastermind Clubhouse chat on how to grow your coaching and training business. Warm welcome to all of our moderators for the day and also all of
Also, all
our
of our
members and
members and
delegates.
delegates.
Okay, so
Okay, so
thank you
thank
all
you all
for
for
joining
joining
us.
us.
So over to Guna and Sachin, the moderators of today's talk, and let's go along with their flow. Over to you, Guna and Sachin.
Yeah, so though we have a lot of things to ask, in 2020, the coaching industry is boomed like anything, but what is completely different in 2021 compared to 2020? And how do we utilize this opportunity, like Clubhouse or anything else? Can you just mention that?
Oh, I believe 2021 is an amazing new decade. It is just not a new year opened up for coaching industry. I think it's a new decade itself opened up for coaching industry as such because thanks to COVID, it has allowed all human beings to learn everything online, and it has given opportunity for a lot of online-based education. So there are a lot of myths and mistakes in our life we have done, and there are a lot of information stuck in our head, and a lot of people are waiting out there to learn from us. So obviously, it has opened up an amazing opportunity for all of us to share, to inspire, transform people, at the same time make money. So it's not just 2021, Guna. The whole decade is available because this is going to be a sunrise industry, the whole coaching and training industry. This opportunity was once I've seen in American and Western society 25 years ago when Jim Rohn, Tony Robbins, Brian Tracy, and all these stalwarts actually opened up the whole self-development industry. So I think some kind of a revolution is happening right now, the same way that in India and also outside India, this is an amazing opportunity. So let's utilize this opportunity and let us learn, let us expand, let us impact a lot of lives, Guna. And Clubhouse is one particular app, an amazing opportunity available for all of us, wherein which you're all chatting right now. Over to you.
That's awesome that we are in the community which is in the sunrise industry. Yes, and we are in the right time at the start itself, so we can actually have a lot of we can take the best advantage as a first mover in the industry as of such. And also I think in Clubhouse also not every trainer is already in, but our community starts actually I see a lot of our members are already started doing so many sessions online, and I think that's well said by you. Thank you for that. And but as we always see one problem in which all the trainers and coaches is this implementation. Yes, we are being an implementation oriented focus group. We are helping and we are doing a lot of such. But can you just tell some tips on how they can implement quickly? Because even this Clubhouse downloading, setting up the bio, etc., though some people know that it is important, it is simple, but still some way they couldn't implement it immediately. Something or the other is making them procrastinate. So how do we actually make everyone implement quickly, and how, and as an user, as a trainer or a coach, to improve one's implementation ability, the action speed, etc.?
This is not just only members of TLC's challenge of implementation. It is a humanity's challenge itself, no? Because 1% of the world implements what they know, and that's the reason 1% of the population has 97% of the wealth and impact in the whole world, no? So implementation has always been a challenge with everyone. Why? Because the biggest enemy for implementation is the laziness and the constant distraction by the society and by the other social media channels, where we are always consuming information because the whole world wants to grab your attention, your mind. That's also one of the reasons why we are all not able to implement. Okay, so that's the reason I keep telling to all of our members, to everyone whomever I meet, that with respect to social media, don't be a consumer, because then you will become addictive. Then you will become your DQ will go high. DQ means distraction quotient will go high. And you will not implement whatever you are learning. Okay, so you will have the wish and desire, but it will not become your success. So that's the reason why in social media you need to be a consumer, not a consumer, but be a giver. Okay, and to all of you guys, whoever is attending today's talk show, In a moment, I think we will open up Q&A from all of you. So whoever is interested, sometime from now, you can raise your hand to come to the stage as a, and you can ask the questions and share also. But in the meantime, if you guys like whatever we are saying, we can keep on pressing. If you have the mic on, you can actually press the mic on and off. That means that's one symbol of clapping also in Clubhouse. Okay, so that's the reason why in TLC, you know, we are putting all the efforts in helping all our coaches and trainers to learn every piece of technology. Even today's talk show is also one particular way of making sure all of our members participate in a Clubhouse chat, understand the whole, the technology behind how to use it, how to talk, how to unmute and everything. So that we want all of our coaches and trainers to open their own clubs and inspire and, you know, we call it a tilt in TLC, right? Teach, inspire, lead and transform. And that's the whole objective. And for that, we need to be a giver in social media, even in Clubhouse, not be a taker. Only givers don't get addicted. They actually are always giving more. So one of the best suggestions from my side is let's all use Clubhouse in the right way to start our own clubs, to start our own rooms, because each and one of us have some amazing information locked inside our head with our experience, with our mess in our life. Let's openly share with everyone, and a lot of people will get benefited because of that. That's what I believe, and that's what I am also doing. Every day I'm participating in different Clubhouse rooms, not only just the room I'm hosting, but also the rooms where someone is also talking. No? So thereby, I can add value, deliver value, and interestingly, I'm growing my followers continuously. And so all of you who are listening to this, just check the profile of each and every speaker on the stage, and also the people who are all attending inside the room. And if you like their profile, go and press follow button and check out their Instagram profile and say that you also will learn something from the way in which the profile is organized, the way in which they inspire the world, so that that will be a very good use and advantage. So, Guna, implementation comes with small, small things, not in big, big things. Even right now, if you are listening to it, one thing you can implement right now is press the click the button of the speakers and also the listeners. Check out their profiles, click the follow button over there, because implementation starts with small, small micro rituals in our life. Thank you, Guna, for asking that good question.
Yeah, thank you. That was awesome. And I think be a giver and don't be a taker is something which I think we need to follow, because if we start consuming the content in Clubhouse or any other social media, I think we are going to waste a lot of time, and we can redirect that to our implementation. Thank you for that nice nuggets. And now, Sachin, you have any questions, Sachin?
Yeah, thank you, Vina. Thank you so much for giving to me. Now, thank you, Guru Murli, for reminding all of us what implementation is all about and how it can be done. And now this Clubhouse is reminding me of that new girl in the town that everybody's after her. So I think everybody is now jumping on Clubhouse, and that's why, again, a lot of audience out there who is waiting for your content. So go out there, utilize this platform to build your credibility and your brand as well. So Guru Murli, I would like to ask one question, and this question is especially for those coaches who are aspiring coaches or trainers who really want to, who has that passion, who has that the goal is to impact people's life. Now, what is that checklist you will suggest for a coach or a trainer that they should keep in mind when they're starting their coaching or training journey?
Oh, number one checklist is, am I very clear why I have become a coach? And number two, what is that I'm really, really, really good? Even in the middle of the night, if you wake me up, okay, what is that one thing I can actually share and teach? Okay, so that means that comes out from your skill and experience in your life. And number three, you have to ask yourself, okay, if I teach this to someone, is there a target market for this? And is that target market willing to pay for this? And can I just do it like a play, not like a real work? So this is the most important checklist we all need to check first, whether we are in the right direction or not. That's number one. Once that is done, then once you jump inside this particular industry, the more importance we need to think of every day, we need to invest on continuous learning. It means we have to listen a lot, learn a lot to upgrade our own knowledge. Not just to, just learn from other people and copy and share. To understand other people's perspective and reflect within us how we can also share our experience in the same way. So we have to learn a lot every single day. at least 15, 20 minutes or 30 minutes of learning is required. That's one of the most important checklists I follow in my life for my personal growth. That's the reason I end up in studying 200 pages every single day. And number two, most important checklist is learn technology. Without learning technology, I think it is not possible for any coach and trainer to actually grow their career in this postmodern COVID world. So it's important to learn tech and technology. So every day I spend at least 15 minutes to learn a new technology. Last 10 years I've been consistently practicing this, 15 minutes a day to technology. And number three, you need to spend time for marketing a lot. Okay, most important thing, some kind of marketing. Okay, so though there are too many social media channels are there, I would always suggest everyone find where is your target audience and be there in that particular area. Okay, if your target audience is in Facebook, spend a lot of time in Facebook by posting at least one or two messages in your Facebook, or do at least Facebook Live very frequently. If you have your customers, youngsters in Instagram, do Instagram Live and spend a lot of time in Instagram creating some amazing posters. If you think that your audience is in YouTube, go there. And right now, you know, the whole world is flocking towards Clubhouse. If your audience is there, come here and start creating the following. But don't try to do everything. That's what I would always suggest, because then we will waste all our energy. Become a superstar in one channel first. Anchor yourself strongly, and then you start moving to every other channel. So that's the number three checklist in our button every single day. And the most important thing is your rest, and your little bit of rest time is required. And last but not the least, some kind of preparation is also required. If you are going to do some any kind of a sessions or talk shows, you are going to host everything, or you're going to speak in a forum, or you have a training or a coaching, all these things are required. So that means your work time. So there are various things that we need to focus upon at the same time, because we are juggling multiple balls, because all of us are coaches and trainers. But more importantly, we need to focus on marketing and sales, because without marketing and sales, you may be the best in the world, but the world has to see you as the best. So that's the reason you need to spend a lot of time on marketing and sales. So based on your lifestyle, you need to plan all these things. Then only it's possible for us to impact a lot of lives. Okay, so I hope I answered your question, Sachin, in a different way.
Yeah, thank you, Guhimurli. I hope, absolutely, you have shared your nuggets. I'm sure most of the members must be getting the insights, how they can, again, if they are existing coaches as well, what are the things they need to take care of. Thank you, Guhimurli, for sharing that. And absolutely, it's all about learning. Keep on adding value to yourself, so that again you can give out to your customers or your clients, your audience as well. Thank you so much for sharing that. Now, next question that I would like to ask is, now what will be your thoughts? One question that I always get from a lot of coaches, trainers that I'm interacting with across the globe is that how to manage time when you're doing all the things, you know, by yourself, by themselves. So how to do that? How to manage time?
Time management is a myth. Okay, there is nothing called time management. It's all about energy management. Okay, it's all about priorities in life. Okay, so if you have 100x energy, it's all about how do you going to put these energies in different places. So for that, we need to be ruthlessly clear what exactly we want in our life. The number one reason why people mess up with the time is they don't know what they want in life. And this is what I learned from my teachers. Rich people spend a lot of money to save time. Poor people spend a lot of their time to save money. Interestingly, money can always be earned, but time cannot be earned a lot. No? So we need to know which are the things that we need to be done. We only in the world can do, the others cannot do. So find all the activities. This is what I also did. It's not that rocket, it's actually easy to figure out, but it took a lot of years for me to figure out, because in the beginning part, I was only doing everything. And then I realized that I'm burning out myself too much by doing everything, by admin, marketing, sales, delivery, planning, preparation, sending proposals, everything I was only doing, including the social media marketing, designing and Canva graphics, everything I was doing. But then later I figured out that I'm burning myself a lot. All my time is getting wasted. So then slowly I started delegating work to my team or to an outsourced agencies. I know that's going to cost us money, but the minute we outsource it, you know, we have to pay for them. So obviously you'll end up in putting more focus on sales and marketing to get new sales. And that's how you expand. So you are putting a positive pressure on you Thereby, you end up in focusing more on sales and marketing and can get new customers. So that's the reason I told you, step one is always be very clear what you really want in your life. And then based on that, you focus on your energy of your whole day. So whenever my peak energies are there, I do the most important things. And whenever my energies are down, I do the dull and the boring important things like admin task and checking Excel sheet and all the finances and admin and bill signing and all these things. So that's how I manage my time, and I always request everyone to manage time based on their priorities in their life, Sachin. Thank you.
Thank you, Murali. Thank you so much. Members, you can appreciate the talk by muting and unmuting yourself so that you can
Sachin and
appreciate
Clubhouse,
the
only
talk.
the speakers can have that mute and unmute button. The listeners do not
Okay.
have. I think once they come to the
All right.
stage when they want to ask a question or they want to participate, I think then only it's possible. So are we going to allow
Okay.
listeners also to come to the stage and ask questions, or how is it? How do you structure?
Yeah,
Yeah,
that's
we
what
will. Okay. Go ahead, Guna.
We want to start right now. So we want to keep the floor open for questions because me and Sachin ask some of the frequently asked questions which most speakers already always have this when they are into training and coaching. Now we would like to take all the members. Yes, if you would like to become a speaker and ask your question, you can go ahead. And we are opening this room right now. Yes,
So how do they
please
ask,
unmute.
just a question, how do they show their interest that they want to ask a question by raising their hand, right?
Yes, when you raise the hand, we will make you a speaker and then you will get this unmute option to talk, dear member. So this is how you're going to do. Already we have a few members joined us. So Preeti, go ahead, Preeti.
Yeah, good evening, TLC members, and thank you so much, Guru Muli, for hosting this wonderful Clubhouse talk for us. My question for you is that on Clubhouse, how can people get connected to you? Because here you cannot connect via chat or messenger. So basically, if they are participating and if somebody wants, is interested in you and wants your services, how can they get in touch with you?
Okay, I think there is some. Okay, yes,
The
he's
most
back.
important thing is that you need to fill your bio sheet perfectly. Okay, that's the most important tool here, because in Clubhouse there is no chat functionality available. So that's number one, to fill your bio sheet. Maybe add all your name, email ID, phone number if possible, people to connect with you. And most importantly, fill your Instagram, connect your Instagram and Twitter, because from Clubhouse they can actually connect to your Instagram profile, and then they can directly message you. The last 1 month, I have got a lot of followers to my Instagram profile, a lot of direct messaging happening. People are all joining my other free lead magnets and my free courses and all. So that's the way in which you can actually connect, Preeti. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you. Thank you for answering that question. Now we will go to the next person. Nimish, you can ask your question, Nimish.
Good evening, everyone.
Hi.
I just wanted to add to what Guru Murali said before to Sachin's question. I fully agree with Guru Murali sir that you have to manage your body energy cycle, and based on that, do the important works. The other key element is you don't need actually manage time. What you manage is the events that happen in your life during the day. If you can manage those events properly, time will manage itself, because if your meetings keep dragging on, that means you've not managed that event correctly, and that's why the time management has gone to the front. So in nutshell, you need to manage the events correctly and time management will happen on its own. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Beautiful perspective.
Yeah.
Now, to all the audience, if you guys want to
Thank you,
ask
Nimish.
anyone any question, you can raise your hand, you can come to the stage, and Guna and Sachin will moderate and ask one by one.
Hi, I'm Hari here. I
Yeah.
have a
Hey, go ahead.
question. As a
Yes,
trainer
Hari.
and a coach for people like us, what is the prime time when we can host this Clubhouse meeting so that we can attract more number of listeners to our club?
Good question, Hari. What I see is that a lot of coaches and trainers are presenting between 5 a.m. to 6 a.m., 6 a.m. to 7 a.m., and 7 a.m. to 8 a.m. in the morning. And then after that, most of the speakers and coaches I'm seeing somewhere between 5 p.m. in the evening to all the way up to 9 p.m. and 10 p.m. Okay. You know, I was once in a host, I was supposed to speak for 15 minutes. Meeting had started at 7 o'clock and I had to go out at 8 o'clock. But they were not closing the meeting. Next day morning, I figured out that they closed the meeting at 2:30 a.m. Okay, so that's the time people invest nowadays in Clubhouse. But my suggestion is you fix a day and time. Okay, you fix a time for your kind of audience to whom you are serving. For example, if they are working class of audience, then you need to plan it accordingly. Okay, so if you think that your topic is predominantly more on positivism and all, put it in the morning. When the mind is fresh, you can inject the positivism inside them. So depending upon your type of audience, Hari, plan it. But there are many speakers and coaches who have started doing it daily 1 hour. Okay, so stick to one particular schedule and plan it and implement it, Hari.
Okay. In terms of this promoting about our Clubhouse meeting, so could you suggest, you know, what are the ways we can
to promote the Clubhouse? A very good question, because many people think that if I come to Clubhouse and I start a room, it will be filled with lots of people. No, it is not. See, for example, today it is a meeting where a lot of TLC members are there. Why? Because we invited a lot of our TLC members to be inside this particular room. And if it's going to be an open room, then I think it's always better to first build your followers in Clubhouse. Okay. Tell all your friends in WhatsApp and email and all to join your Clubhouse room, and then create a room and then start marketing them in Facebook by putting a design in Canva and put it in Facebook and put your Clubhouse URL and send WhatsApp messages to all your contacts and followers and students. Send an email to everyone. If possible, send an SMS to everyone. That is another way. And also, whenever you're doing a Clubhouse chat, invite a couple of moderators and speakers and ask the speakers also to share it into their following base. So thereby you get a lot of followers and listeners to your Clubhouse room, which will help all of us to grow our followers. Okay. Thank you.
Okay. Sorry, I have one more question if you
thank
don't
you,
mind.
Thank you, Ari. Ari, can we go with other members? Because we want to give opportunity for everyone.
Okay.
Thank you, Ari. Thank you for understanding. And dear members, once you want to ask a question, the moment you ask the question, please mute yourself again. Whenever you're talking, only then please unmute yourself. Otherwise, you can keep yourself mute. And we'll go to the next person. Srinidhi, you can unmute and ask. Yeah. Your voice is very low. Can you please be a little louder? Yeah.
I think you can't hear her voice.
No, Srinidhi, it's too low. It's too low.
Is it fine now?
Yeah, now it's okay. Now it's okay. Now it's okay.
All right. So, yeah, I was just saying that I was following both of you in a couple of other networks and I found your work to be very interesting. So I joined the room. So basically, I've always been into some sort of training or the other from the start of my career. But now considering COVID, the corporates are, cutting down on costs. So for few trainers like us who have largely worked on a corporate training, we might, lose out on such an opportunity. So for people, for such dull times, what sort of new career opportunities would you advise to somebody who is a trainer? That's my first question. And secondly, I wanted Murali sir to talk a little bit about his happiness coaching, if it's the right platform.
In any kind of a business, Srinidhi, there are two kinds. One is called a sunrise industry and one is called a sunset industry. 7-8 years before itself, my teacher told me that corporate training is a sunset industry which will go down. It has reached the peak and it is going down. Why? Because corporate companies are not interested to really skill their employees. They want their employees to come skilled and they will only give technical knowledge only, because people are hopping and they get some increment, they are leaving. So corporate training is actually a sunset industry. It's a going down industry. And that's the reason why I slowly moved out of corporate training and started building my profile in the open market. there are two things happened. The minute I promoted myself in the open world and started doing a lot of open training and written my book and became an author, my authority and visibility and credibility increased a lot. And those companies who are paying me less, who are negotiating more, now they suddenly see a different profile of you and they invite you to come and speak in their company and they pay you 10 times more also. That's the funny thing that happens. Okay? And more, and since you said, no, this is a very good time for freelance trainers, corporate trainers, to start getting into the open market space. You know, in TLC, that's what we teach in our TLC mastermind community, which I created some time before. And it's a mastermind community where we actually help a lot of freelance trainers and corporate trainers to figure out what kind of a business model that they can create in the open market, how they can create multiple products, coaching products from their intelligence and package it and present it and create a brand out of them. So that is something which you can do, Srinidhi. So maybe you can start doing a lot of open seminars and open workshops. And for that, you need to brand yourself, build a little bit of your authority. The easiest way we teach in TLC to all our members is write a book and become an author. Okay. So because whenever I ask everyone out of 10 people, eight of them say, that, yes, I want to become an author. But they don't write it because they delay it. They procrastinate. In TLC, we made a mandatory process that every member has to write a book and we completely coach them and guide them. We have an in-house publisher to ensure everyone writes the book. So that's the fastest way to build your authority. And thereby, you know, you can actually say that you're an author, you're a trainer. So a lot of followers will start coming. And at the same time, learn technology to convert your offline course knowledge into an online courses and start selling these online courses as a membership programs or as online courses, recorded courses. And that's what we teach in TLC also today. And a lot of our members have started doing that a lot. So thereby in the next one decade, okay, it may take little 1 year for you to build your credibility, build your visibility, and build your branding. But by the end of next year, you are well known in the whole market. Everyone will know you. You become a brand. And thereby in the next 9 years, you will have an amazing corporate career. The interesting part is you will find a lot of corporate companies approaching to you instead of you approaching it to them. So that's what happened in my life. Number two question of yours, happiness coaching. Though this is not the right room, but still, I teach happiness through my Unlimited Happiness mobile app, an Android and Apple iPad. You can see that link in my link tree in my profile. And you can download that and I teach everything, most of the things for free. But if people really want to learn more, I teach it through my online community called Unlimited Happiness Community. And every month, I also teach happiness through a very simple implementation of breathing and meditation exercise. Every month from 1 to 4th of every month from morning 6 to 7 via Zoom, I teach simple techniques of breathing and meditation. Thereby, you automatically become happy because if you ask me frankly, I do not know how to teach happiness to anyone. I can only teach you how not to be unhappy in your life. Okay, so I hope I answered both your questions, Srinidhi.
Sure. I was very inquisitive about the happiness coaching because another thing is I run a network where a lot of coaches can come and teach. I have somebody who teaches music. I have somebody who teaches dance. So I'm also looking at adding several courses actually. And I found your course to be interesting. So probably we can connect offline on how
absolutely,
we can work.
Absolutely. Thank you. Thank you.
Sure. Thank you. Thank you, Gunasan. Thank you, Max.
Thank you. Thank you, Srinidhi. Now we will go with Nagaraj's question. Nagaraj, if you're there, you can ask your question or we'll go to Gautam. Gautam, please unmute and you can ask your question.
Yeah. Good evening to all of you. Gurumuli, someone like me who is transitioning to a new career, I superannuated last year and now I'm working on a diabetes reversal and anti-aging. Now, for someone like me who's yet to step in, I mean, I have accumulated a lot of knowledge writing a book. I think I have a fair amount of expertise, but I've yet to, come out with them with my business model. So what would be your advice to me?
See, Gautam, one of the simple business model is remember the traffic light signal, okay? The red, the orange, or the amber, and the green, okay? So there are three kinds of people who are going to come into your life. Absolute strangers, people who are following you, and people who are liking you. So when you're creating a business model, and the reason why you are doing it, because you want to help a lot of people. So there are a lot of people waiting out there to learn from you. So create your business model should be such a way that you first be familiar and, be brand yourself and be visible in YouTube and Facebook. Give away all the knowledge and content, whatever you have, shamelessly share with everyone so that more people will get benefited. So that more strangers will become followers for you. And create a lead magnet like a free course or a free webinar so that these strangers who are following you, they will slowly come into your funnel. Okay. So that's called the green button. Okay. They're like the traffic light green. So that means you have captured their attention and they're slowly coming into your funnel. And there are some more people who like you. They may come back to your website or they come back to your YouTube channel or probably you have a blog. They come back to you. For them, you need to ask them, okay, now come and attend my free course or a small 99 rupees course or maybe a 1 week program where I'm going to teach you all these things. So that becomes your conversion program where you're teaching them something, valuable lessons to them for maybe for free. It's up to you, maybe for free, or you charge them a small Guru Dakshina for that. And once they come inside, that's called the orange in the traffic light, okay? Because they're following you. They like you. They already know who you are. Maybe they want to know a little bit. And once they come inside, you need to have the red offer, the bright one, the big one, the meat of your program, probably your one-to-one coaching or one-to-many coaching, we can actually invite these people. So whenever you're creating a business model, create these three tiers of businesses. If you study the book, Start With Why, our Simon Sinek beautifully talks about how best organizations in the world become the best because they always talk about the why first, the how second, and then the what. Last only they will talk about what they do. Similarly, as coaches and trainers, your first interview in first level product of your funnel should be the why. Why are you doing this and why people should become aware of it? Like as a diabetes reversal specialist, educating them, bringing their awareness should be your front end free lead magnet program. And then how to handle that. And what is that they have to do? So that can be a step-by-step process so that you create three products. So that's how you start building your business model. That's how you start it, okay? It will always evolve as you move forward step-by-step. The best suggestion is listen to your audience whom you are attracting. They will tell you exactly how your business should flow, okay? So that's, I hope I gave you some suggestions today.
No, thanks a lot. That's just quite a handful, and I think I need to think and reflect, note, and take.
Thank you,
sir.
Okay.
Good evening, sir. Thank you, Gautam. Nagaraj, please go. Yeah.
Okay. Good evening, sir. Good evening, Guru Murli. So now today, this TLC have joined very recently, and I have already gone through your niche identification course. And there I identified my niche as a student success coach. And I have already written one book on this. It has already come out recently. It is named as My Dear Students. And it is only about the student mentoring. So even in this one, also I decided to go ahead with the students only as student success as my niche. But recently one of my professor who I met, what he was saying is, so if at all you are choosing the students, so you can do that very well. But the thing is, just now as you rightly mentioned, will they pay for it? Because since they are not earning themselves, they will not be able to pay for that. So that's why you have to choose any persons who are general public. That means those who are earning themselves, like those who are working in a corporates in such area. So that would be better choice, he said that. That's why I want to know your opinion. Is it right advice or what?
It's not about right or wrong. For example, I'll give you an example of Sandeep Maheshwari, one of the best speakers, and I have heard, I believe you also know that he attracted students a lot. He shared a lot of knowledge and built his whole career as a speaker. Okay, so thereby what he did, he presented everything for free, motivational speaking to the students only, and he became super famous. And he was able to inspire and transform thousands and lakhs of lives. Okay. So it's all about the choice that we make, okay. Dr. Nataraj. Because if you are so passionate in changing the lives of only the students, then you stick over there. That's okay. The more and more you start teaching them, it will come. they will start following you. It doesn't mean that they don't, though they are not going to pay money, but remember, students' pestering power is your strength. Okay, so they will always find ways to get money. And I know Gunashekaran in this room from the age of 20, when he was in the engineering college student, while he was a student, he was able to even start his business itself. Okay, so while he was a student, still he was able to make money. So, Dr. Nagaraj, I think students can make the money. It's not that they can't make the money, but I think it's all about how you structure your whole courses in such a way you also bring in the parents inside somewhere inside your whole community. Because when we are empowering students, it is a three-party agreement. No, it's the teacher, it's the parent, it's the student also should be involved. See whether you can bring in some kind of a parents inside your whole community somehow, maybe as a graduation ceremony or an appreciation ceremony or some kind of a process, there in which parents also see what our students are doing. Okay, so thereby it becomes easier. Okay, I hope you got some ideas on that. But if you think that you want to step outside the whole students market and you want to get into the parents market, again, it's an another Pandora box. For the last 10,000 years, people are all struggling to teach one subject called parenting. It is not only you, it is many people are struggling.
Yeah.
So, whichever you are comfortable, only you have to focus upon. That's what my suggestion is always.
Yeah, because all the last 25 years, I put it in with my life is only with the students, teaching and this one. At present, I'm a principal of a college. So, right, I started as a lecturer, all those stages. So, that's why my competence, my passion, everything lies there with the students only. Students, and just now, as you said, even with the parents also it lies. I think I can think of involving them also in the same circle. That's a very good suggestion. Thanks a lot for this, sir.
Thank you, Nagaraj. Thank you. We will go to Sai. Sai, you can ask your question. Please unmute. Yeah.
Hello, everyone. Hello, Guru Muraliji. So earlier you have mentioned about how do we test our idea with the audience and determine whether this is a good course to start with, and how do we size the market or the demand for that course. If you can throw some light around those areas.
There are two ways to start any business. Either you test out market need with your product, or as a coach or a trainer, what you are really damn good at it. Okay. Just start sharing this with everyone. Okay? And, it took a lot of time for me to stay with my passion area. What really I wanted to share as happiness, because no one is searching. They are searching for different solutions. Money making is faster. If I have named myself as a money coach, I would have become a billionaire by this time. Okay. So it's not about testing the market. It's all about start implementing and start teaching whatever you know first. Thereby, your audience will come and tell you what exactly they want. Even for example, TLC, when we started, I started off as a one-to-one coaching. I thought that, okay, because I wanted to, share my knowledge and create more coaches and trainers. And the first thing I did is, can I do one-to-one coaching? And then slowly I said that, okay, this is taking too much of my time. Then I said one-to-many. After doing one-to-many, then I said, okay, can I do zero-to-many by recording everything? And there was a larger audience. COVID came, fortunately, and a lot of people started buying recorded courses. But then after that, people really got bored with recorded courses and they want live classes. Then we moved into live classes. And then we found a challenge that people are not implementing. And then we evolved the whole business into a mastermind community meeting itself. So, moral of the story from my life experiences, you need to start somewhere. Okay, start somewhere, anywhere. It doesn't matter. Don't think too much. Just jump inside whatever you are passionate about, whatever you want to really share. Just jump and start sharing. And just listen to your audience. The more you listen to what your audience are continuously complaining, there is your business model. Okay, so just open your ears and listen to all the complaints that your audience is giving. You will find an amazing business model. They will tell you what they really want. Thank you.
Thank you, Muraliji.
Thank you. Thank you for asking that question. Now I'll ask Dr. Suyog. You can unmute and ask.
Good evening, everyone, and myself, Dr. Suyog. I'm an organization development coach.
Suyog, please unmute yourself. You got muted again.
Hello. Yeah. Thanks, Guna. So Guru Murli, I have attended a few sessions with you in TLC. So not a, it's a very simple and basic question I have is that this is the first time I'm attending a Clubhouse session, and I want to add more followers to me. So of course I'm going to share with everywhere, but how we can nominate someone, because I have seen that somebody has nominated to me in this Clubhouse and I became follower to him. Like that, I have a lot of people invited. How I can nominate them so that they can be a part of?
Oh, first of all, you need to be familiar with Clubhouse by participating in various rooms, Yog, and start building your followers. As you start building your followers, a lot of people will start inviting you to their forums also, and start going to various forums and raise your hand and come into the front and share your opinions, share your views, or if you want to ask a question to the speaker, go ahead and ask the question to the speaker. Okay, so thereby you will start creating more followers, and at the same time create your own club, because Clubhouse gives you an opportunity to start your own club itself. As an OD coach, you can create a HR club where you can invite all the HR managers or HR heads whom you know, and you bring them and you start your own room and probably run a panel discussion on various challenges HRs are facing in their life. Okay, so maybe every day host a show like that. So thereby, you know, if you invite a HR to that particular panel as your speaker, they will invite all their employees in their company to the Clubhouse, because they want their team members also to hear, know what they are speaking. So thereby you increase your followers, you increase your credibility. At the same time, these other HRs also get benefited in the whole process. Okay, I don't know whether that's what your question is.
Yes, yes. Thanks for answering the question.
Thanks, Dr. Suyog. We'll go to Akhil. Yes, Akhil.
First of all, many gratitudes to Guru Murli. Because of him, I am now working as a time management coach. So many gratitude, sir. And the question is, sir, when we create any of the course, like I started with weekly webinars, then I moved to 5-day live classes and everything. But at some times, after doing it 5 times or 10 times, we get bored. We found it really repeating again and again, and we found less energetic. So what should be done and how we should maintain our energy in repeating the courses?
I thought only I had the problem. Looks like even my students also have the same problem. Thank you, Akhil. I think people who love variety in life, they will really get bored in repeating the same course again and again and again. Okay, so if you are really getting bored with this repeating the same webinar, same sales webinar again and again, then there are two things to do. Either you add new content, or you change the whole flow so that you don't get bored, first of all. Because that's one of the human needs, no? Human needs, they want constancy, but at the same time, they also have variety. Number one, so it means either you add a lot of variety to the whole content, you innovated, you ask yourself, okay, is there a way in which I can make this whole workshop better? So keep on evolving it so that you don't feel bored with it. Okay, that's number one. And number two, the reason why we get bored also, number of people also reduce, because that's what happened in the whole industry. When the COVID hit, a lot of people started attending webinars. Now it is a declining mode. People are not coming because now they've understood, oh, all these coaches and trainers will invite you for a free webinar and at the end of it, they will sell. Okay. So people have got used to that. They have burnt a lot of money in their pocket and they have not attended many of the courses people have actually bought. So if you are going through that particular cycle, then you need to think of a different business model itself of how you want to serve them. Okay, so maybe using larger technology, like for example, of my friend Rajiv Talreja is using an amazing setup with a software worth 7 lakh rupees and an amazing stadium and setup, or like Tony Robbins, who is running in a larger scale where they can actually bring in the real life workshop feeling. But again, it involves a lot of infrastructure and cost. So either you bring in innovative technology into the whole process to add more variety so that you're also thrilled and excited to continue. Or if you think that, no, this is not the right thing really I wanted to do, probably I want to do something else, then you need to change your whole business model itself, wherein which you are still satisfied in helping the whole community itself. So it's all about the variety, either in the content or in the whole context of your business model, okay, in a nutshell. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Akhil. And now we'll go to Rakesh. Rakesh, you can ask your question.
Yeah.
Rakesh, please be a little louder.
Okay, fine. Mike, is it okay now?
Yeah.
Okay, my question is to Guru Murli is that What happens, sir, when somebody's niche is not matching with these times? As I am an outbound trainer, and my niche is that, you know, I do the practical workshops since last 15 years. And in this COVID time, my niche is not matching with the, you know, one-to-many kind of physical kind of workshop. And somehow, if I shift it on the online kind of setup, so don't you think that it will be damage my image?
No, it's all about how you are going to present your whole self. I understand that you have been an outbound trainer and always been on the outside world, taking people to mountains and trekking and all these things. I also do Himalayan trekking every year, but you know, but I don't put it in that particular way. And I know some amazing mountain leadership coaches. You know what they do? They present themselves in the online world as a leadership coach, and they bring in all their outbound and mountaineering experience, and they talk about motivation and mindset. And do you know what they are actually selling? They're actually selling their club membership of having some interesting modules, and that end module is taking you to a mountaineering every year, at least 10 days in a year, to mountains, either to Himalayas and various places. So it's all about how are we going to structure our whole knowledge, thereby we still maintain our identity as an outbound specialist, okay, outbound expert, and at the same time build a lot of following and build, for example, my teacher Blair Singer, you know, every year he takes people to, you know, Kilimanjaro for leadership coaching, okay. It's a trekking, but he actually converts the whole trekking process into a leadership coaching itself. For example, I go to Himalayas every year, but I convert that into a mindfulness journey and chakra meditation process. So still the whole core is that I'm a happiness coach. I'm holding the same happiness coach, but the whole thing is that I take the people for trekking for a chakra meditation, cleansing and mindfulness and meditation training. So similarly, you can also maintain it, provided you need to create a whole product in such a way that you can continuously teach online with examples and stories, and then you take them slowly from the online world to the offline world. So it's all about how you package it, Rakesh, as a club membership.
Okay, sir. Thank you. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, Rakesh. Before we go to the next question, can you... There are people who just joined Clubhouse and they are not aware on how to use, etc. Can you share few basic tips on how they can use Clubhouse and how they can start first following other rooms and then they can start their own room? Can you add a little bit about these things?
If you are a beginner to Clubhouse, start following personal. First of all, if you are new to Clubhouse, first of all, go and put an amazing photograph of you. And fill your whole bio sheet. Enter your whole biography sheet with add a lot of emojis and icons. Make it more colorful, because otherwise it will be boring to see. So, and make it short paragraph in your biography, and put all your links for your free lead magnet, your YouTube, your website and all these things. That's number one. Okay. Number two, start following various people. Okay. For example, if you click my profile and follow me, you will see that there are 1,600 followers and 110 I am following. Okay, click who and all I am following and see, is there any kind of things that you can relate with those people, and see whether you can follow them, and check which are the clubs that I am following and see whether that resonates with you and you can follow them. So that is something which you have to start doing for people whom you like the content, who you want to learn, because Clubhouse is an amazing place where we can learn, where we can share, and we can also earn by bringing a lot of followers also. And then go and participate in various rooms. Okay, so go and attend some various rooms which are resonating to your topic. Okay, if you are a fitness person, find out who are all people who are doing fitness based rooms and clubs. You can go to that search button and then type the word, and you will find a lot of people over there. And participate in these rooms if possible. Raise your hand, speak and share your opinion. So thereby you will also get noticed and you get a lot of followers. And then you can also start your own club, because whoever is there inside this room, almost most of you I know, you're all coaches and trainers. Start your own club and host your rooms, okay? And start talking about one particular topic, but be very consistent, okay? Don't suddenly come once in a month and do that. You need to be there inside this room every day, because this is a new baby in town and the whole world is coming inside. 10 million users in 1 year's time. Okay, so that's an amazing number. And you know, basic principles in business is what? wherever your customers are, you need to be present over there. No? So better we are all spend little time over here. But again, one caution, this is an amazing addictive tool, Clubhouse. So don't get addicted in the whole process. But instead of, how do you avoid getting addiction is by you participating, you give away content, be a giver so that you don't, get addicted into the whole tool. Fix a time, use your time wisely. Okay, these are some of the basics of how to use Clubhouse. Even in our YouTube channel, in our Facebook page of TLC, we actually have posted a small, we did a Clubhouse chat yesterday on Clubhouse tutorials and basics. Probably we all can just follow that particular audio chat for a lot of ideas also. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you, Murali sir, for answering that. And now I'll ask Karthikeyan to unmute and ask the question. Over to you, Karthikeyan.
Yeah, thanks, Gunasekan, sir. Thanks, Murali, for giving this opportunity, sir. So my name is Karthik Viswanathan, and I'm working as a Joyful running coach. So what I do is, like, I'll take people and then I'll just get them to run their first 5 kilometers or 10 kilometers or half marathons or full marathon. Over the period of time. So with this COVID, I have just made this service as an online product, and I'm just reaching out to different clients, and they're getting their benefits out of it. But my question is, like, this is like a transformation. It is after, like, they need to attend or they need to practice for 4 weeks, and then only they will be seeing their transformation, and then they will be running at the end of it, say, for example, 5 kilometers after 4 weeks. So till that point in time, I will not be getting any testimonials, or I will not be getting any other inputs or any other marketing materials from my clients from there. So in that downtime where they are really getting transformed, how can I able to just promote myself in terms of, yes, there is a product of this nature that exists to the wide market?
You are doing an amazing coaching. Okay, fantastic. Okay, Joyful running coach. Beautiful, Karthik. Now, though you... takes 4 weeks for them to see the results. But if you ask me, right from day one, they are actually started seeing mental results. The breaking of habit, maybe that mind telling them, oh, let's not run today. This is boring. Oh, my body is paining. My thighs are paining. They overcame that because of your coaching and guidance. Okay, because something you said to them that made them to do that exercise that particular day, they did that small bit of things. So right from day two or day three, the forming of habit, breaking their own inner negative voice and building their perseverance and willpower, you know, so it means all these layers are also there until they actually see the end result of running 5 kilometers. No? I think that is also another testimonial which you can actually get it from them even the first week itself. Am I right in saying, Karthi?
Absolutely, sir. Absolutely. But I didn't think in that particular perspective. That's really an eye-opener
for me. In which your coaching can involve everything and you can project it that way. Just not that, reaching that 5 kilometer marathon. It's a sense of achievement. Okay, so get that sense of achievement success story on a weekly basis. What exactly they are feeling. Thereby, that also becomes a success story for you. So just try this particular method. So you will really enjoy creating more and more successful fit people in the world. Wow, you are doing an amazing, amazing coaching. I really envy you now, Karthi.
Thank you so much, sir. Thanks for your input. I'm humbled. Thank you,
Karthikeyan. And Guruvayurappa, you can go ahead and ask your question.
Thank you, Guna. Good evening to everyone in this room. Hi, Murali. Today, I was hosted my event. Today was the third day. And today, I had around 45 people joining the room. And the first day, it was zero, actually. I was the only person waiting for 20 minutes. And yesterday, we were two or three people. And then again, it was just for 15, 20 minutes. Today, it was 45 people in the room. Now, how do I actually market this event so that more people can join? That is one question. And how do I make people to be very precise when they talk in that room? Because some people, they talk for more time. And, that way, the time of the room gets extended. So how do I make sure it is controlled?
Thank you, Guru. First of all, you need to do the marketing bit. And I think you have already answered your question. At day one, you had zero, but today you had 45. So that means consistency. Okay. So it means you have to be very consistently doing it again and again and again and again and again and again. so that people will start following you, and the more they start seeing you in the clubhouse, always you're hosting a room, you will find a lot of followers. Okay, I'm always see whenever I open a clubhouse, my own newsfeed, I see one guy called Dheeraj Global. I have zero idea who this guy is, but then I went to his checkout profile. He was more like a DJ and a production engineer. And you know what he does? He just plays varieties of books, audio books in his clubhouse room. That's it. And you have to see 400, 500 people listening to this guy's. He's not even speaking. One audio is speaking over there and people are sitting and listening. So it's all about consistency, Guru, of continuously doing. Number two, once you have created an event, shamelessly market that event by creating a poster, post it in Facebook, post it in Instagram. If you have a private Facebook group, post it over there. If you have a group, if you're part of WhatsApp groups, post it over there so that more people will get to know about this, so that they will come over there. And attending an event in Clubhouse is very, very easy, as if it's just attending a phone call. Okay. And there is no great preparation is required. It's not a Zoom meeting where they have to dress up and they have to put a back screen, green screen, and all these things are not there. That's the biggest advantage I see with Clubhouse. Okay. So thereby you market your event. Okay. So it's all about marketing ultimately, and it's all about consistency. And ensure that your topic is so simple and easy for everyone to understand. Okay. Follow. And they should also know what kind of questions to ask. So you have to tell them, okay, Guru, you're on the stage. You have 30 seconds. Please introduce yourself and ask a question in 30 seconds. So you need to tell the rules up front. Otherwise, people do not know what to speak. And another best option is if you are the moderator of a room, you should always say, okay, so thank you all for, thank you, Guru, for asking this question. And next I'm going to ask, after Guru Ayyarappa, Karthikeyan is going to ask his question. So be ready. And that's how you prep the person to whom you are going to ask. Okay, the person in the front and people are all in the deck in the back. For whom? After Guru, who is going to ask the question. So thereby, since you have also given a little bit upfront time for them to ask a question, now they know 30 seconds they have to ask a question, so they will frame the question. Otherwise, you know, I have seen people, when they want to ask a question, they will start from the first page. Okay, they will talk about why they want to ask the question, put a big build up for that, and the question will be in the third page only. They will be talking on and on and on and on and on. So there are certain situations in my life where I have said, okay, sir, thank you very much for your first page. Can you come to your second page directly? So if that, again, the mistake is because I didn't tell them how to ask the question. So that's how you moderate your room, Guru.
Okay, thank you so much, Murli. Tomorrow I'll follow.
Thank you.
And again, I'm shamelessly marketing this in our community itself. Please, everyone, join my room at 9 a.m. in the morning. I will share the link in all our TLC WhatsApp groups. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you, Guru. Thank you. And Murli sir, since we are going to touch 9 o'clock where we have only 4 minutes, I have one question. Now what we are doing in this discussion is more of a question and answer discussion where we ask question. And what are the different types of rooms we can organize? Like one you said, one guy is doing audio books. Likewise, can you mention different types of rooms we can have so that sometimes we can do something in the morning, in the evening we can have a different kind of a room and we can attract participants inside our room. So can you?
Okay,
can
so
you
one is a question answer where you invite a speaker. You have some couple of moderators, like how we did today is a sample way of you guys started asking me a couple of questions, and then we allowed participants to come inside and they also started asking questions. So one is a Q&A panel, okay, panel chat or like this question answer panel. Number two is playing audios and playing music in your stuff, or you are just the only speaker and rest everyone are audience. You are speaking and talking to them. But then the most interesting need, why Clubhouse became famous, is because human beings really wanted to share their voice. Okay, in Facebook, they can only press the like or some write some comments over there. And generally, it is all the good things in Facebook they put. That's the reason it's not a Facebook. It is fake book. Instagram is always beauty photographs. Okay, beauty stuff. And YouTube is all videos. Okay, so the reason why I say Clubhouse is becoming so famous is because it's a room where people can voice their opinion. So another methodology is giving a short topic where you allow everyone to come and share their perspectives. It's like a question asked. You are only the moderator. You are not generating any content. you are inviting your audience and they are coming and talking. For example, Guru was hosting a session on fears. Okay, how do you overcome your fears? And today morning when he had 45 people. Why 45 people? Because everyone came onto the stage to share their fears, to share their challenges in life. So that is another model to do that. Okay, so but ultimately, if you're going to use Clubhouse, you need to allow more people to come to the stage so that more voice is being heard, more people share their perspectives and opinions. And another methodology is you invite a great eminent personality into your chat show. So thereby when they come also, along with them, they bring in their followers also to your room. Because the minute they are inside your room, it shows in news feed of their followers. Okay. Oh, they will see, wow, this person is right now inside this room. Okay, let me also join this room. Okay. That's how I ended up in following Grant Cardone. That's how I ended up in following Elon Musk. Because I suddenly saw these guys sitting inside a room. So I went inside and I found some amazing content. A lot of good followers also I got. So these are some of the methods in which we can use different formats in Clubhouse. Thank you, Guna, for that good question.
Super, super. Thank you. So one is a question answer. One is a training where we present and then ask the question. One is a perspective sharing with a common topic which we display and which we already added. And one is an eminent speaker. I think we can use all of this mix and match so that we can definitely get good followers and good knowledge sharing inside the room. So it's 9 p.m. So Murli sir, I'll hand it over to you for the closing remarks and then we can
Thank
close
you. I
this.
I think you have decided to close in
discussion.
1 hour. Thank you very much for that. Okay, so thank you all for being here inside this TLC Masterminds. Please do follow TLC Masterminds. And please check our website www.teachersorleaders.org. Please attend our mastermind meetings. If you have not attended our mastermind meetings, it's a closed group of coaches and trainers. We help each other to grow each other's business. And we are planning to host a lot of talk shows here. Everything related to coaching and training business, specifically focused for coaches and trainers inside this room. We will be hosting it very frequently and regularly. So please follow our TLC Mastermind group so that all of us can get benefited. I thank all the moderators today and also all the members and listeners who came up and asked us a question. So whatever I know, I shared my answers today. I hope it was useful. And every day we will keep on doing this a lot, I believe. I hope Guna and Sachin are going to do every day. If you're going to do every day, then I think we need to plan our time accordingly. So thank you all for being here today. Thank you.
Yes, yes. So,
yeah.
So,
thank you. Thank you, everyone. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Guru. Thank you, Guru Murli. And thank you all the members for asking your questions.
You.
Hope it
thank
was beneficial
all. Thank
for
you.
All of
Good
you.
Night,
yeah.
Thank you, sir.
And
thanks a lot, sir.
We will keep you posting about the next the session when we'll be having in our WhatsApp groups and your respective mastermind groups.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you.
All right.